फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स। नंबर वन ड्रग्स ऑफ एब्यूज, नंबर टू ड्रग एडिक्ट, नंबर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ ड्रग्स, एंड नंबर फोर लेटेस्ट ट्रेंड्स, एंड नंबर फाइव डिटेक्शन ऑफ ड्रग्स इन FSL एंड चैलेंजेस एसोसिएटेड विद देम। एंड वी शैल ऑल्सो डिस्कस सम ऑफ द केस स्टडीज ड्यूरिंग माई प्रेजेंटेशन। होपफुली वी विल फोकस अवर प्रेजेंटेशन एज पर द FDP प्रोग्राम। एंड nowadays it's a very very burning problem for youths, and our country is facing so many problems on this particular topic. And as we are working in the FSL, we found various types of probabilities and difficulties in analyzing such type of compounds. So it's a very good platform to discuss these things with you, because you are nurturing our future forensic experts for catering the service of country. So I'm going to start. So kindly share my presentation and begin my presentation. Please show the slide. Move on to the next slide. Okay, so as we all know, drugs are so commonly used and abused in modern societies that virtually everyone has some familiarity with the concept of drug addiction and abuse. Drugs that affect behavior are particularly likely to be taken in excess when the behavioral effects are considered pleasurable. As we know, drugs are meant for curing some disease, but some drugs are to be misused for pleasurable effect. So this creates some problem in our daily life, and it is going to be related with drug of abuse. Please, next slide. Now the question arises, what is drug of abuse? Next slide, please. Is simply excessive use of a drug or use of a drug for purpose for which it was not medically intended. We are debuting in the area where several medicines are to be appeared in on day-to-day basis, and these medicines or drugs are to be misused for pleasurable effect. So this is known as drug of abuse. When we use a small amount of drug for curing disease, it will be act as a chemotherapeutic agent. But when it is used not as a medical intended, then it will be known as drug of abuse. Next slide. Basically, in the case of drug of abuse, we encounter a word narcotics. The term narcotics derived from the Greek word known as stupor, originally referred to a variety of substances that dulled the senses and relieved pain. It produced insensibility to external stimuli through depression of the central nervous system, but now applied primarily to the drugs known as opiates compounds extracted from opium poppy and their chemical derivatives. Narcotics are the opioids, chemical compounds that are wholly synthesized but which resemble the opiates in their action. So the important question in narcotics is a very broad subject, but since we are dealing with drug of abuse, this type of terminology will be used again and again. That's why we have cleared this particular point here. So it is derived from Greek word, and the meaning of narcotics is to be sleep inducing substances. Next slide, please. Now, narcotics have a high potential for abuse. As abuse drugs, they are sniffed, smoked, or self-administered by more direct routes of subcutaneous skin popping and intravenous injection. Drug effects depend heavily on the dose, route of administration, and previous exposure to the drug. Aside from their medical use, narcotics produce a general sense of well-being by reducing tension, anxiety, and aggression. These effects are helpful in a therapeutic setting, but can contribute to their abuse. Means, I mean to say, these substances initially were taken as a medicine, but these have some kind of habit forming. Therefore, these are included, or it is treated as drug of abuse. Next slide, please. The question arises, does using opiates cause dependence or addiction? Answer is yes. Dependence is likely whether using large amount frequently or occasionally over a long period of time. When a person becomes dependent, finding and using the drug often becomes the main focus in life. As more and more of the drugs are used over time, larger amounts are needed to get the same effect. This is called tolerance. Withdrawal signs usually begin shortly after the user's body expects its next dose of narcotics. What happens in the case of narcotics? In our brains, there are so many receptors. These receptors are called dopamine receptors. As we all know, our brain is divided into three parts: frontal, parietal, and occipital lobe. All the lobes are involved in drug addictions. Initially, when a person takes an amount of drug, gradually it increases the amount because it develops some kind of tolerance. And once a tolerance is developed, a next thing arises that is called abusing. Now, when a person leaves this particular amount, a withdrawal signs generally develops there. Next slide, please. Next slide. Now, question arises, what kind of categories we can categorize these abusive substances? There are so many types of classifications are given in the literature, but since we are dealing different types of faculties here, so it would be better I have categorized into a simple categories in like narcotics, depressant, stimulant, hallucinogens, cannabis, and steroids. Generally, these types of compounds covers our whole subject here. So we will discuss these particular subtopics one by one in the slides, and you will literally know about what we are going to be tell here. Next slide, please. Number one comes here, narcotics. These drugs initially developed for relieving the pain. As we know, the terminal patients of cancer and having a severe pain, they generally doctors use morphine injection there. So drugs used medicinally to relieve pain, high potential for abuse, but this create abuse. So this particular narcotic substance causes relaxation with an immediate rush, initial unpleasant effects like restlessness, nausea. The example of these types of substance generally covered list is quite big. I mentioned some of here like opium, morphine, codeine, heroin, hydromorphone, mepridine, methadone, etc. Number two comes, next slide. Number two is depressant. Now depressants, these drugs are medicinally used to relieve anxiety, irritability, tension. Again, it have high potential for abuse, development of tolerance, produce state of intoxication similar to that of alcohol. As we know, after taking so much amount of alcohol, person becomes sluggish and sleepy. Combined with alcohol, increase effect of multiply risks. So these compounds are quite dangerous and easily available in the market. Generally, the category in this category, so many compounds are available in the medical stores like barbiturates, methaqualone, tranquilizers, chloralidate, glutathimides, etc. And we all are aware regarding tranquilizers like valium and diazepam, nitrazepam, oxazepam, lorazepam. These drugs are easily available nowadays in the market. These drugs initially were used by as antidepressant. So person suffering from insomnia or person suffering from depression, generally doctor prescribes these types of compound. These have these substance have similar types of effect like alcohol. Next comes, next slide. Stimulant. Now this is the next category of drugs known as stimulant. As the name indicates, these drugs used to increase alertness, relieve fatigue, feel stronger and more decisive, used for euphoric effect or to counteract the down feeling of tranquilizers or alcohol. So this type of substance get stimulates person in somewhere to counteract their say sluggishness. Example of these substance is cocaine, amphetamine, methamphetamine, phenmetrazine and methylphenidate. This type of compounds nowadays used by students, since we all know there is a lot of competition for night awakening, the students are consuming amphetamines. And you might have heard in the case of Rahul Mahajan, where that fellow have used cocaine. So after taking this type of substances, person get stimulated and act accordingly. Next comes hallucinogens. As the name indicates, these types of drugs produce behavioral change that are often multiple and dramatic. No known medical use, but some block sensation to pain and use may result in self-inflicted injuries. In this particular hallucinogens, now next category is to be added, that are known as designer drugs, which is made to imitate certain illegal drugs, are often many times stronger than drugs they imitate. These types of drugs synthesized in clandestine laboratories. Generally in hallucinogens, compounds have been used PCP, engine dust, love boat, LSD, and mescaline, psilocybin, and designer drugs like ecstasy. We will discuss these further in our next slides. Next slides, please. In narcotics or in drug of abuse, mostly all the scenario rounds generally utilize three types of plant products. One is Papaver somniferum, another is Cannabis sativum, and third one is Erythroxylum coca. So I will discuss one by one. Kindly focus on this particular plant. This Papaver somniferum or opium plant, generally cultivated in Mandsaur areas with some kind of license and other formalities. because we need some medicines for chemotherapeutic purposes. That's why these plants have been cultivated in our area. As we all are aware, in the COVID area or in the COVID pandemic season, we have so many persons used Cody Star and cough syrups. That is also a product of Papaver somniferum. Next slide. This Papaver somniferum gives us an important product that is known as opium. So that's why Papaver somniferum plant is also known as opium poppy plant. This poppy plant name Papaver is generated by Greek word meaning poppy, and somniferum is a Latin word to induce sleep or create the dreams. In this particular plant, opium is generated by giving incision on the capsule by some sharp weapons or some pin-like material, which gives us a milky white latex, which on aging effect gives brown and blackish semi-solid material, which is known as opium, which have a bitter taste and characteristic odor and smell. In our Indian opium, when we purify it, we get mixture of 25 types of alkaloid with meconic acid and porphyroxene. The main alkaloid of opium is morphine. Another are so many types of alkaloids are there: morphine, codeine, thebaine, papaverine, nascopine, narcotine, etc. As we all aware, this morphine is main culprit or the main drug for the pain relieving. And in our law, 0.2%, less than 0.2% of morphine is exempted from the punishment. That's why we use, say, a poppy seeds in our condiments and spices. Generally, we utilize khaskhas in our food. It's a very rich, proteinous material and have less than 0.2% morphine. But if we carry this particular seeds in UAE or other countries, they will penalize us. So the first product is opium. Next comes, next slice. Next, generated from opium, that is smoking opium. Next slide. Next slide. The other product of opium is smoking forms of opium like chandu, madak, inchi, joga. This chandu is boiling small pieces of opium with water. And madak is mixing of leafy material with concentrated solution of opium with latent sugar. Again, inchi is charred residue. So you just see all the parts of opium has to be used by the drug addicts by different types of names. Even the remaining part and shells of the capsule, that is known as doda kukki or capsule doda powder, have been used by truck drivers on highways for awakening in night and having a relaxing effect on them. Again, it is easily available in highways, that is known as doda kukki, but in NDPS Act, case has been registered for carrying such type of products. Next slide. Another important compound generated from opium, as I told you, opium gives us morphine, and this morphine has to be acetylated by acetic anhydride, which generates heroin, or chemically it is known as diacetyl morphine or brown sugar or smack or gur. It have a bitter taste and more potent than morphine, and it is dangerous drug if taken by mouth. Generally, drug addicts use this substance either by nose sniffing or by subcutaneous injection. It affects on central nervous system and induce depression and reduction in sex. And this type of material in international market is available in around 1 kg is equal to 1 crore rupees. But when it is circulated in our scenario that they add different types of cutting agents like paracetamol, Bonvita, tea, coffee, etc., which is it create a lot of stuff to get more earning from this. So in Indian scenario, we get a brown sugar. Actually, diacetylmorphine is a white colored crystalline compound, but when they add some cutting agents, it becomes brown in color. So it is known as brown sugar or gur or snow. Next slide. This heroin, the structure of this heroin is given. It is a base is morphine. Morphine having two acetyl group. This acetyl group releases in our metabolic pathways and becomes monoacetyl and morphine. So DAM, diacetyl morphine, get converted into monoacetyl morphine, and monoacetyl morphine get converted into morphine. So it's an illegal drug and available in our market. And lot of casualties are happening, and so many persons are indulged in selling and purchasing of this particular compound. And in the area of Indore and Ujjain, in several parts of MP, this substance is circulated. Street heroin. Next slide. Another compound extracted from Papaver somniferum, that is known as codeine, and it's a very useful compound, especially in cough syrup they use codeine. And nowadays so many types of cough syrups are prepared in India, like Fansidil, Codistar, etc. It is to be smuggled to Bangladesh for misusing them and again creating a problem for enforcement agencies. So nowadays this type of cough syrups are generally sold in market with prescription to avoid the misuse of this particular compound. This codeine is purchased from opium alkaloid factory and utilized by pharmaceutical companies. Next slide. This is also available in market, that is known as morphine. This morphine is acetylated to create heroin. Next. There is a basic difference, morphine and diacetyl morphine, only two acetyl groups are there. So that was the plant number one, culprit number one was Papaver somniferum. Now we will discuss our culprit number two, that is cannabis sativum. Next slide. This cannabis sativum plant is easily cultivated in our atmosphere, and the plant looks like marigold plant, like we generally use marigold flower in our worships, yellow colored Genda fool. It looks like that. It have a 5 to 7 feet height. The flowering tops of this plant is known as ganja, and leaf are known as bhang. The seeds of this plant are known as ganja seed. It is very rich in protein and generally used in preparation of sauce in hilly regions. Next slide. This plant gives several products in market. it is known as marijuana or marijuana. In plant is to be used as Indian scenario, our sadhus and devotees of Shiv Shankar Bholenath utilize different parts. They are more sophisticated in using of this particular plant. Some of them use leaves, they are known as bangeli, and some use flowering tops, they are known as ganjeli, and some of persons using another plant product that is known as charas or hashish. Initially, cannabis plant were utilized in, say, reward giving substance. In 11th century, Mussolini legend used hashish or hashishin. It gives rewards to those fellow members which generally perform assassination of important persons. So the different part of this particular compound, this particular plant is to be utilized. So ganja, bhang, and then charas and hashish. The main component of this plant is delta 9 tetrahydrocannabinol. There are different types of cannabidiols, cannabiniols, and tetrahydrocannabinol in this particular plant. The most amount of delta 9 THC is found in charas. So charas, how it is to be prepared? Generally, when in bushes of these plants, a leather jacket wearing person visit there, a sap is to be attached on their leather jacket, and they scrap it and prepare a charas from that. Charas is a very costly substance, and just know, bhang, ganja, charas, this all related to cannabis plant. Next slide, please. This is a chemical structure of delta 9 THC. So these type of drugs are important. Nowadays in US, they are using as recreational drug, and some of the compounds of this plants have been utilized as anti-cancer compound. And they are, in our India, it is covered in NDPS Act. In the US, they are going to put it into a recreational use for, it's a very important compound, and it creates hallucinogens. And you might have also sometimes, at the time of Shivratri, when a person takes, say, bhang or ganja, it creates some kind of hallucinogens. After taking bhang, so many persons report that the fan is moving and we are listening a bell of, say, temple in their ears. This is all due to delta 9 THC of this ganja. Next slide, please. Cannabis sativa. After cannabis sativa, the third plant, it is a very important plant. It is known as coca plant. I'm going you in the world of these drugs one by one. So first we have discussed papaver somniferum, that is opium plant. Then we have discussed cannabis sativum, ganja plant. Now we are going to discuss coca plant. This coca plant, it looks like this, having some red seed-like material and green leaves, and it is also known as Erythroxylum coca. Next slide, please. This coca plant having important stimulant. This stimulant stimulates central nervous system. Chemically, it is known as benzoyl methyl egonine. It is obtained from coca bush or cultivated in South America. This plant is the native plant of South America. Egonine, it is a chemical base of cocaine. So previously, In USA, it was used as a general tonic. It was the wonder drug in 1880s. Park Davis company have developed so many leaves, cigarettes, coca ointment and coca cordial, coca extract, cola nut. Then they have developed Coca-Cola. But when they came to know that this compound is a stimulant and creating abusive types of properties, they have banned this particular compound. And initially, it was used in Coca-Cola. Still, we don't know. They do not give us the perfect formula of Coca-Cola. They are still using some kind of cocaine in that. It creates some kind of addiction. You may also find some person regularly drinks cold drinks. So, but they are saying that we used say cola leaves or coca leaves, decocainized coca leaves. They have been using it, but who knows what kind of things they are actually using. Again, less than 0.1% of cocaine is exempted from our punishment by law. So they are, I think they are taking benefit of that in our India. Otherwise, internationally, it is totally banned compound. So this is a central nervous system stimulant. After taking cocaine, a drug addict becomes so stimulant, so active, he may jump from the 100th floor of the say building. And some of the criminals have used this particular compound for creating some crime, or it is very important to use there. Next slide. The cocaine, it is generally prepared by leaves, as I told you. In cocaine, it is classified as narcotics for legal purpose because it creates strong psychological dependence. So cocaine like looks like this. And it is again a heterocyclic compound. Next slide. Now, what is drug dependence? Drug dependence is psychological and sometimes physical state characterized by compulsion to use a drug to experience psychological or physical effects. Drug dependence takes several forms. Number one, tolerance. Number two, habituation. And number three, addiction. Now, in drug dependence, you must know all the three things. What is tolerance, what is habituation, and what is addiction. So tolerance is a form of physical dependence occur when the body becomes accustomed to a drug and requires ever increasing amount of it to achieve the same pharmacological effect. When a person take opium, initially if a person is not taking opium, he may be sedated by 0.1 milligram. But gradually, if we take this particular amount, this amount will be increases. Then second stage is developed, that is known as habituation, which is a form of psychological dependence. It is characterized by the continued desire for a drug even after physical dependence is gone. And then comes addiction, which is a severe craving for the substance and interfere with person's ability to function normally. It may also involve physical dependence. So just focus on these points: tolerance, habituation, and addiction. It is the important aspect of drug of abuse. Next slide. The intensity and character of physical symptoms experienced during withdrawal are directly related to the particular drug of abuse. The total daily dose, the interval between doses, the duration of use, and the health and personality of the user. Now, this is a very important point. After taking these drugs, there are several changes takes place in the body. These leads a person to another world, and that is known as drug of abuse. And From here, a disaster begins in particular person. When a person gets trapped in the environment of the drugs and he or she becomes helpless to get rid from these particular compounds, and this particular state is known as drug of abuse. Next slide. Next slide, please. Now, what are the symptoms of these drugs? Generally, when we look on a drug addict person, you will find some abscess at injection site. As I told you earlier, this type of drugs generally taken by the injection. So they have some kind of drowsiness or slowed pulse or constricted pupils and respiratory depression. They sometimes generate nausea, vomiting, constipation, and several needle marks on the extremities, euphoria, lethargy, lack of motivation, flushing of skin on the chest, neck. Except in cases of acute intoxication, there is no loss of motor coordination or slurred speech as occurred with many depressants. Now it depends on which type of compound person is going to be used. According to that, symptoms have to be developed. Next slide, please. Now, when a person takes drugs, they do not have control on that, and they overstep and have some overdoses symptoms. These overdoses symptoms generally having shallow breathing, slow pulse, clammy skin, pulmonary edema, respiratory arrest, coma, convulsion, and possibly death might take place. Next slide, please. So it is very dangerous. And the most thing is that this particular thing, when you see, this is a very important part when in case of drug abuse, when you see the withdrawal symptoms, you will wonder, you will say that we will not get indulged with this type of substances. The withdrawal symptoms associated with heroin, morphine addictions are usually experienced shortly before the time of next scheduled dose. So person have to take a dose after certain time. They have some runny nose, teary eyes, excessive yawning, restlessness, irritability, nausea, low of appetite, chills, shakes, flushing, muscle jerks, and nodding, sleep, severe depression, sometimes vomiting. At the point of during this process, a suitable narcotic substance can be administered. You might have seen a recent, before last year, a Bollywood movie appeared in our market. That was, movie was Sanju. In that movie, they have shown Sanjay Dutt was indulged in some kind of drugs by the friends, and they have initially taken, ganja. After that, they have taken cocaine, heroin, etc. So the different parts of withdrawal symptoms are nicely shown in that movies, and they have a withdrawal regime have shown in that movie how motivated Sanjay Dutt have left out these drugs and again returned to the Bollywood. So if you want to visualize this type of withdrawal symptom, generally I visit in drug de-addiction centers to do some kind of research for. I generally encounter these types of effects in the de-addiction center. For the de-addiction, they use different types of regimes for removing this withdrawal symptoms. We will discuss in next slide. Next slide. When an opiate dependent person stops taking the drug, withdrawal usually begins within the 4 to 6 hours after the last dose. The intensity of withdrawal symptoms depends on the amount of drug taken, how often and for how long. These symptoms for most opiates are stronger approximately for 24 hours to 74 hours. After they begin to subside within 7 to 10 days. Sometimes symptoms such as sleeplessness and drug craving can last for months. It's a very genuine fact, and we observe in drug addicts. Next slide. Now the question arises, if a person indulges in drug addiction and he or she wish to withdraw these drugs, so they have to follow some treatment or de-addiction program. The basic approach for these abuse treatment are detoxification, drug-free program, or some chemical compounds like methadone. Again, as we all know, iron cuts iron. So narcotic substance cuts narcotic substance. Methadone have been used as drug of choice as a substitute of heroin for removal of withdrawal symptoms. And they have different types of drug regime in their clinics, and they generally utilize them. So different types of treatment procedures are there. We are not discussing here. Next slide. Next slide, please. Another, as I told you, methaculone is used to remove withdrawal symptoms in drug addict. But again, clandestine laboratories preparing this type of methaculone and used as drug addiction. So this particular compound is available in the illicit market, brown, gray, or black color, and prepared by anthranilic acid, ortho-toluidine, acetic acid, phosphoric acid, or phosphorus trichloride. And generally, it is available in the form of tablets. So again, it creates a problem for enforcement agencies. Next, please. As I told you, that amphetamines, bandidine, dextrins, these are stimulant of central nervous system, having same effect as cocaine. This is generally utilized by students for awakening at nights, and again it causes some abuse and some addiction in the student, and having so many types of side effects. But again, this compound is creating problem for us. Several de-addiction program also using different types of, say, compounds to get rid of these amphetamines. Next, please. Next slide. One more old compound were also there that was known as LSD. It is a hallucinogen. It was first recovered by fungus growth, and a fungus develops this LSD. Lysergic acid diethylamide, which is a testless, odorless white powder and highly potent drug. And this is also used in sugar cubes and as in injections. But a single dose creates a disturbance for over a year. So some of the criminals have also utilized this particular compound. Next slide, please. Now, major threat is coming to our country in the form of, say, drugs. Several, chemotherapeutic agents nowadays have been utilized for different types of, crimes and different purposes. This includes, several tranquilizer tablets like Valium, Diazepam, Barbiturates. The important thing is that the important target for these drugs is our, girls or young girls. Some of the tricksters are nowadays using roofies or rofinols. It includes some kinds of benzodiazepine and utilized in, rave parties, in club scenes or club drugs. Some of more drugs are also available in the market that is known as mephedrons or love drugs or MDMA, Ecstasy. These are generally prepared in clandestine laboratories And one more thing is that they are also utilizing GHB, gamma hydroxybutyrate. The important this particular compound is like that. If we utilize a drop of say GHB in drinking water, it do not create any taste or any kind of color or any kind of smell. So it is easily used for raping our girls in parties. So for that we have generated so many protocols. Girls should not accept say water bottle or drinks, open drinks in the parties. The important feature of this particular compound, after taking this particular substance, 4 to 6 hours, a prey or girl do not reminisce what happened to them. So person utilize this particular compound in raping of girls. So it is a very important compound, and club drugs available in the market. Be aware about that. And the important of this particular lecture is that we must be aware about these deadly drugs debuting in the market. Not only that, I'm not going to say utilizing this information in a way that you must not accepting, do not relying on your colleagues. But this type of things are happening in our societies nowadays. Next slide. Next slide, please. One more compound is debuting in our market. Seriously, it's a designer drug kind of a substance developed from, say, Dhatura plant, scopolamine. It is also known as card drug or Barandanga. Structure is given. This type of compound, when given to a particular person, victims after utilizing this particular compound have some medical attentions to be required, and generally the victim becomes, say, in a coma condition. So the persons which having some eyes on the belongings previously in the train robberies, some traditional substances like Dhatura were also used for taking belongings. Generally, Indian Railway have put it so many slogans in the platforms for not taking eatables from unknown person. It is a kind of newer substance that is known as Barandanga, and so many cases have been reported after in airport. They are utilizing so many types of GPS devices and this type of compound for robbing a particular person. Next slide, please. Now, as we are Indians, we were focused on basically 3 to 4 plants or some of the compounds like cannabis sativum, opia, papaver somniferum, and rhizoxylum coca. But nowadays, so many new plants but products have been debuting through internet in our country. It is an important plant. It's known as khat plant or khata edulis. This khat plant is a flowering plant. It is native of Ethiopia. It is used as tobacco. It creates euphoria. The important compound found in this particular plant is known as catechins. So this catechin again create addictive properties. So this plant may be abused in some of the, say, Ayurvedic preparation available on the online. So if a person takes a particular product from a company, they register use this plant to create again and again purchase same company product. So khata edulis is again a problem for us. Next plant is it is known as kratom Mitragan specio, tropical evergreen tree. It is a coffee family, native to Southeast Asia. It is indigenous to Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, Myanmar, Papua New Guinea, where it has been used in herbal medicines since it is at least. So it is again, this type of product have opiate-like properties and stimulant-like effects. So some of the, say, Ayurvedic preparation might have used this type of product in their in compounds. Next. The major threat is coming in our India in the form of NPS, that is known as new psychoactive substances. It's a major threat. Now the question arises, what is NPS? Next slide. These NPS are drugs which are designed to replicate the effect of illegal substances like cannabis, cocaine, ecstasy while remaining legal, hence their previous name was legalized. And new psychoactive substance began to appear in the UK drug scene around 2008 and 2009. They fall into four main categories. You know, what I'm going to tell you, previously criminals were using ganja, bhang, afim and other things, but they are now so clever, they are utilizing these compound in a newer way. They are carrying these substance illegally, indigenous way, innovative ways, so enforcement agencies cannot trap them. Next slide, please. In opiates we found like Papaver somniferum plant gives opiate, and cannabis sativum gives cannabinoids, and say rhizoxylum coca gives cocaine. So they have generated synthetic cannabinoids. So there are so many types of NPS. One of them is synthetic cannabinoids. They are selling in our vicinity, like they are mimicking cannabis. Now what they are creating, clockwork, orange, black mamba, spice, exodus, they are selling these product, this plant material in a very fancy and pouch packets around in our schools to create drug addiction. And these are substances we are not very much aware. Suppose so many times we have found in Delhi, student were asking to a particular shopkeeper, do you have a bath salt? I told them, what is this bath salt? He gave me idea that he is demanding some kind of drug. Next slide. So in the category of NPS, second comes stimulant type of drug. It includes mefedrons. Now we are facing this mefedron in Bhopal also. It is also known as meow meow drugs. They are selling in Bhopal, and we have seized, confiscated this material and identified these. So these particular substances now available in Indian scenario. Another category is downer or tranquilizer. They are creating pyrazolam, flugonazepam, etiazolam. Next slide, please. Next, please. Another, they are creating hallucinogens, drugs like LSD, bromo dragonfly, ketamine, and Bombay. Much media attention to given announcement of these significant numbers of new drugs. Now, in the current scenario, such type of compounds, I think in overall in the world, around 1,000 to 2,000 new compounds have been debuting. These compounds are creating havoc in the society and creating problem for forensic scientists also. and we are not aware. Daily new drugs have been debuting in our market. Next, please. And the main threat, our youth, these substances are purchasing online from, different websites. When agencies have knocked these particular website, they are using some kind of deep web, dark web, and purchasing these particular substances in the form of bitcoins. They are not involving money. So it's again challenge for us, and these are easily available online and persons are using. Next, please. So what is the main concerning area of drug addiction? That is drug addict, drug selling. Sometimes drug sellers become prostitute, informer. They do forgery, cheating, drug peddling, blackmailing, smuggling drugs, and they sometimes prepare syndicate or racket to sell these particular substance. So it is a very big threat for our society. Next slide, please. Generally, when this type of persons have to be arrested, according to Narcotics Control Bureau, these particular substance to be analyzed in the FSL. Next, please. And they have given so many types of list of compounds in that, which types of compounds is punishable, but it is to be tested first in forensic laboratories. Next, please. Since we have a very big scope in this particular topic and we have little bit of time, now we comes on the how we identify this particular compound in forensic laboratories. We generally perform analytical methods, and we perform two types of methods in our laboratories generally, that is qualitative method and quantitative. In qualitative method, what is present in the stuff, it is important. We generally report what kind of drug is present in particular confiscated or seized stuff. And another thing arises, that is what quantity of that particular compound is present in particular amount of seized product. So we perform qualitative as well as quantitative. In qualitative, we generally perform chemical spot test, thin layer chromatography, or GCMS spectroscopy. But in quantitative, we perform so many types of instrumental techniques, and we utilize several sophisticated instrumentation. So I'm not going to discuss here, because as I came to know that our senior member, Dr. Baghi Saab, will cover that sophisticated instrumentation part, and I will show you. Next slide, please. And what kind of we utilize gas chromatography. Next, please. Gas GCMS chromatograph. Next, it's a graph of GCMS. We identify a particular newer compound through the library match. Next, please. HPLC. Next, please. LCMS. And LCMS, MS. There are a list is very big, and problem is lying in new psychoactive substance. So it is catalyzing a shift in FSL practice also. The exploitation of different plants, toxins, synthetic chemicals, and the collective knowledge of drug production has increased that tremendously in the world of information explosion. And everybody is nowadays aware about the internet knowledge, and they are embracing all the situation, and it is a global epidemic. Newer compounds have been sold in the market, and this problem is not for Indian scenario, It is a problem for whole world. They are facing issues. Next slide, please. And since we in our FSL, we identify and compare these compounds, so collection of these compounds is a very serious problem, especially these designer drugs like spice, bath salt, fentanyl, analog. So these are creating a very big problem for analysts, and I think it's a right platform to discuss, because some of our faculties will indulge in research, say development program. So they focus on these particular substances because they, in coming coming time, we will face more and more problems of these particular drugs in our society. Next, please. We have to develop rapid processes for analyzing. And another problem is that forensic drug is examining is considered to be very, say, monotonous and has never been visualized and evolutionary, because at the end of the day, the credit goes to either enforcement officer who are instrumental in the use user, or the policymaker who walk away with all, say, eclat. For placing a drug or precursor, again posing a severe problem. You know, precursor is also important in NDPSF, because a person is carrying opium, that is okay. If a person is carrying acetic anhydride, it is again a punishable offense, because he might be use it in preparation of heroin or other thing. So this type of drug database should be created. Next, please. It's a very big topic. I would like to draw your kind attention for some of the virtual and real cases. Since I am a forensic scientist, I'm not speaking say any literally things. We are say conducting examination in our laboratory, so we'll have we are bound to show you some of the cases. So I would like to show you, in one of the case, a person was hiding their illicit drug in say anti-allergic drug, but police have clear-cut information that person is carrying some drug. I have analyzed this particular of say several injection vial and say syringe, and we have found that heroin was present in this particular stuff. And so we have reported there chlorphenamine mellitus and street narcotic stuff by detection and identification of applying our simple methods. Next, please. Sometimes in as forensic expert is to work for say masses, we should also work for innocent. A person was carrying a white powder, police trapped them, but we have identified that particular substance was urea, not was the NDPS substance. So again, we have proved our utility to save innocent person, and sometimes some say confusion might be there and some wrong information is there. Next, please. In the region of Gwalior, some person have used say tranquilizers, and they have break the jail and carrying their jailmates out of the jail. They have utilized say very simple lorazepam in the tea kettles, and this case have been solved by RFSL Gwalior, and we have found some tranquilizer in that, and we have reported accordingly. Some person was doing some service for say jail warden, and one of the inmate have utilized this particular tranquilizers and get rid of it, and this type of case also been faced by us. Next, please. Now nowadays drug of abuse involves so many types of things. When you visit in Bhopal area or other area, some poor persons, they do not afford some drug. they are utilizing some volatile drugs in the form of say puncture or tire rubber solutions. They generally take and inhale some of the vapors. Some person utilize petrol. So I have to show you some kind of glue sniffing cases are there. So it is also considered in the say drug of abuse. Next, please. In one of the case, we have found that a poor fellow beggar found dead at the crime scene. I visited there and found some of the say pain eraser, the eraser like things. He was taking volatile substance abuse, and on the basis of that he get some kind of kick and found there. And it was the month of say May or June, so due to heat stroke he may die. And this case was solved. So again, it was related with drug of abuse. Next, please. And now again, a threat is coming on the internet. When I was posted in 2016 in Sagar, FSL Sagar, I found some of students were using electronic cigarette. And out of curiosity, I have collected this electronic cigarette from them and found there is a different types of synthetic substances they were using inside. Aside from cigarette, they are using this electronic cigarette. Now, central government have banned this type of cigarettes. These were also available in the, say, UAE market or on the internet. Some of students are purchasing these electronic cigarettes. It should be banned, having some say volatile narcotic substances, designed to synthetic substances. Next, please. There are so many types of compounds we are facing in our day-to-day analysis. Since time is running very short, we have assigned for say 60 to 90 minutes. It is very difficult to cover all the aspects of drug of abuse. And the good thing is that this FDP program, having so many glittering stars, they will discuss one by one all the things. And hopefully, university have conducting a very good program for drug of abuse. And this program has been utilized by masses, and it is time to be highlight this problem in our country to save our children and our future. Now I am going to open this particular session for question hour. If you have some kind of questions or doubts, you are welcome, and I'll be happy to answer that. And hopefully I have tried my level best to explain these all things in a very lucid and simple form. I am not applied say complicated things, because in our learning, learning should be very simple. Now over to university.
Thank you, sir, for your knowledge-worthy talk. I request the participants to raise their hands if they have any queries. They can directly ask the questions to our speaker. The feedback link will be shared shortly in the chat box. Now, may I please request respected Baggy sir for his remark.
Sir. We had a very good lecture from Dr. Dhingra. It is very informative and collected with a lot of information packed in 1.5 hours lecture. It covers many of the aspects of the LDPS. And some of the things like glue sniffing, etc., though they are not covered under NDPS, but they are of forensic interest. We definitely receive cases which are not covered under NDPS Act. So many times we are told whether these are covered under NDPS or not. So that has to be differentiated. Of course, in a given time, he has done full justice of it. Otherwise, you know, this lecture could be run into 6 hours or more than that with all the structures and the chemistry of it discussed and the instrumental analysis put in. It takes a lot of, in fact, this may be a unit which can run into 15 hours lecture, which could cover in detail for the forensic science programs. So, in a, what do you call, bird's eye view, he has given every aspect of the drugs of abuse, psychotropic substances, designer drugs, and other miscellaneous things like glue sniffing, etc., which is a part of the forensic work, but not of the NDPS. So, lot of what do you call stress has been given by him on the designer drugs, which we are going to receive. Yesterday, I was telling you that coming 10 years, we would be receiving many of these designer drugs. And also, he has covered that the percussor chemistry, that is clandestine laboratory, when they visit, what are the chemicals found, and we have to prove in the court of law that they have used a particular synthetic process, let us say for amphetamine, by seeing the chemical, because amphetamines can be manufactured by 3 different synthetic routes. So, by the chemicals present, we can say that which synthetic route has been adopted by the culprits. So, these are very important aspects for the forensic science, but for the time limitation, we could not cover each in detail. I'm sure that in future programs, we could be more integrated, specified areas we can work where we can go into the details of it. But it definitely has opened the eyes of the faculty. They can grope in through the internet and other books and literature and learn about that. So, congratulations to Dr. Dendra for a nice presentation. And I hope that the faculty and the students have learned a lot from this lecture. And more details they have to, I mean, he has opened the door. You have to go and then explore what is there inside the hall or room. So that is what is required. Many, many areas he has covered. Not only one slight suggestion or maybe a correction is that LSD effects remain for 1 year. Dr. Dhindra has stated in this one of the slides, but I am doubtful that information may be, have to be checked once again. In fact, maybe chronic effects will remain for, because if a person is a drug addict for a long time, those effects will remain for 1 year. But the immediate effect of the drug may be there for 3 to 4 days, what I have read at least. That is the effects of the hallucinations, what the addict will exhibit, are limited to 3 to 4 days. The brain damage which occurs in the regular addict of LCD, LSD and mescaline or psilocybin, psilocin, all these will affect the brain when chronic use is there. But those effects are not exhibited by the addicts after 1 year or so. Brain damage may occur. Certain faculties may be lost and all that. But the effects, what we call it as a trip, if people take LSD and go for 3 days, 4 days to some other place, they don't remain in their house. They that is called as a trip by the students, youngsters who take, you know, where the distortion of all our senses takes place. so they don't want to remain to be seen by their parents or wards. So therefore they go out, and the effects will be there for about 2 to 3 days. As low as 14 micrograms, that is enough to give you a trip for 2 to 3 days hallucinations. That's what I wanted to add. Once again, I congratulate Dr. Dhingra and the university for having a very good, lively lectures. And this is a, what do you call, exposure to the students, what is there. And naturally, in this given time, we could not have gone into the details of each. As I told you, it takes a lot of time, and his resource can be used for more detailed lectures like this. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your kind word. Actually, I was giving this particular sentence in my slide. In some of the cases, they have reported their biological system have been deteriorated or say altered for say one year. It is not a common fact for all the cases. Generally, you have rightly said 3 to 4 days is sufficient, but in some of the cases, some kind of damage might be there. They have recorded that after 1 year, they have been distorted. It is not.
Second is behind that.
Yeah.
They are not visible
symptoms. Yeah.
Visible symptoms of an addict.
Yeah.
That is. It's a small correction. You don't mind.
No doubt. Your input is always valuable. Since we are dealing with faculty development programs, so I told that the information giving in such a way that they create some kind of interest in that. Yes. Otherwise, we will just write it.
Dr. Dhingra?
Yes, sir.
Thank you for giving a very introductory knowledge about the narcotic drugs, but there is something has to be checked. Just you go through the definition of the designer drug.
Yeah.
In slide number 4 or 5, you have included mescaline and peyote and LSD under the heading of designer drug. These are not the designer drug. Fentanyl is designer drug. You just see the
slide. Actually, I would like to. You are right, sir. Actually, the focus of my study was that every kind of molecule nowadays is explored by the chemist. They are utilizing cannabinoid molecules, they are using opioid molecules.